Welcome to Lohre Farm, everybody. This morning, I'm with Van, and we're gonna get going on a project. Pretty simple. We got a clothesline that we installed a couple of years ago, and I didn't do a very adequate job to start with. I kind of just threw it in the ground, and so we're gonna make that repair this morning. Sarah and Libby, they're getting the pool out of the basement, and we're gonna get that all set up. So it should be a pretty fun day. We'll see how everything turns out. Stick around and enjoy the show. I'm gonna encourage you right now, if you're not subscribed to our channel, go hit that subscribe button. We appreciate it. We enjoy doing these videos, and the more people that get to watch them, the better. Well, Van's getting the wheelbarrow already. I'm not wheelbarrowing stuff over this morning. I'm feeling lazy. So on my drive, it's probably about 150 yards, but that's all right. I'll just drive right on over here, and then I don't have to move the concrete anywhere. Drive it right up on next to the spot. How's it looking over there? Oh, this isn't too wet. Yeah, this should be fine. I think what we'll do is we'll take the clothesline down. Yeah, let's get all those clips off of there, and we'll take the clothesline down. And then from there, we can take the posts out. Now, the real hero of the clothesline isn't me, it's my father. Here's a nice picture of him from back in the day. What do you think? You think it's going to rain?
I'm a little afraid it's going to, and I'm debating aborting this mission because of it.
Yeah. Oh, I think we're okay. Well, why don't we go with the fact that it's rained every single day for the last month and a half? So.
Do you think I should abort?
No, I think you should keep going. All right, Van, did you turn the water on? Wonder if we can move it a little bit to the west so it's sitting on the plastic a little bit better.
Which way is west?
Well, we'll check on the pool progress a little bit. I think we filled about 10 inches so far. I think Sarah filled for about 3 hours today or so, maybe 2.5. But that's one of the big drawbacks of living out in the country is, you know, we have a well, so we're using well water, and in order to make that happen, I basically have to run everything through our water softener. We tried filling it last year using the well water, and that was a complete disaster. It looked like chocolate milk in there, and we ended up having to drain the whole thing, and then thankfully we have an outside soft water spigot. But yeah, we got to go a little at a time. I got an old softener, so unfortunately I have to go a little bit and then regen the system and, you know, go a little bit more. I'm sure there's some smart plumbers out there that are laughing at me, but that's okay. This works. We'll get her filled up. I think I'll do a couple more hours tonight, and then hopefully tomorrow by maybe when we get close to lunchtime, we'll be full. So we'll see how it goes. We'll be playing in the pool, and the kids will be swimming in no time, and everybody will be having fun. So on the flip side of the pool situation, I did get the clotheslines concreted in. So got some dirt around there, and it's supposed to rain later tonight. So I kind of piled up the sand around it, get that sand to soak down around everything and make it nice and neat. I'll talk a little bit more about these posts later on. How's it going, Deuce? What do you think? Just hanging out with the ducks? Yeah? All right. Boy, you guys got that done up pretty good over there. You guys are digging down a long ways. I should have had you out here helping when I dug down there and put all that mesh in. Yeah, you. Especially you there in the gray looking at me. Yeah, I see you. Yeah, I don't know what the deal is. It's not like you guys don't have food. I know you're looking for stuff. That's your nature. Find them little bugs. Well, this used to be my John Deere 826 till I was cruising along one day, snow blowing the outside of the driveway, and it went clunk, clunk, clunk. And that was the last of that. So you can see the motor sitting down there. What I should do is I should give this to my brother-in-law and have him tinker around with it. He could probably make all kinds of cool stuff with it. I'll put his channel in the description down there so you guys can go follow him. He's always fiddling around with nonsense, thinking that he knows what he's doing. So most of the time he does, but I just like to tease him a little bit. But anyways, the cool thing about this John Deere is that after it kind of went kaflooey on me, I took the best parts and, believe it or not, that weather vane out of it. The entire thing was made out of John Deere snowblower parts. Basically just kind of made myself little stencils and hand drew the rooster and welded her all together and got myself a weather vane for the top of the barn. Well, welcome to day two of filling the pool. I was gonna say that it wasn't raining for 5 seconds, but turns out I'm wrong. So guess it is still raining. So Sarah's over here. She's working on getting the pool filter all set up. Nothing better than wet destructions.
I know, I'm debating if I should wait till it passes.
When's that, next year? It's gonna be a lot of swimming in the rain, I think, this year, Libs.
Quick water and the pool's under.
The other thing that I've done today is I got a really cool gift recently, but to me, this thing's pretty cool and it's really special. So I ended up getting this dome seat that when they tore down the Metrodome, I think they sold these things or something. I don't know. Well, I wanted to come back out and kind of just encapsulate the end of this video and saying, well, first off, I got to rush out here because apparently it's going to storm again. So that's just all that happens here is it just rains, and I guess we're making up for last year. So last year was pretty drought. This year is just going to be nothing but a storm. But anyways, I wanted to talk about these clotheslines a little bit. As silly as something could be sentimental, the clotheslines probably are the top of the mountain. But we ended up getting the clotheslines from Sarah's parents. They were at Sarah's house. The house she lived and grew up in. And I told her that when we got them, I said, you know, when I was a kid, I was fortunate enough to know my great-grandparents. And when I would go over and spend time with them, oftentimes my grandmother would have to do laundry or whatever, and she would take me out with her out the clothesline. And one of the things that she would do is just set me down on the ground, and I would probably play in the grass and different things like that. But one thing that I noticed when I was down there was that at the base of the clothesline where they were concreted into the ground, my great-grandfather had stuck marbles inside of the concrete when he put the concrete down. And I always thought that was really, really cool as a kid. And I remember him telling me that he had done that because it made my grandmother happy. And I always have taken that memory and thought about it, and a good memory of my great-grandparents. And so when we put these clotheslines in, I had been given the original marbles in when we would go to her house and play, and I still have them to this day, and I took some of those marbles. So it's kind of a combination of several memories, combination of Sarah's house being that the clotheslines were there, and my great-grandparents' house where the original clotheslines were, and then also the marbles that I played with when I was a little kid. And so anyways, I pushed a bunch of those down into the concrete and kind of just have that lasting memory. But I think I'm gonna run in before it starts storming. Thank you. Have a good night.